We asked the question going to break, could UAB be that group of five team this year, like we saw Cincinnati last year or every year, that makes it to a New Year's Six Bowl? Expectations are high. And so we bring in head coach Bryant Vincent now to join us, brought to you by our friends at Legacy, Legacy Credit Union. No matter where you are in life, start building a legacy you can be proud of today. Legacy, the official credit union of UAB. Coach, I'll start with this. It seems like 30 years of being a broadcaster, every time I talk to a coach, he'd always like one more day, two more days. Would you like to have another week, or are you ready to get out there and see what you got?
I would actually like to kick off in about 2 hours.
Ready to go. I like that.
Fall is a lot of work up to a season, coach. If you've experienced this a lot, did you feel like it was an A-plus fall camp leading up to this? A B, where would you put your fall camp?
Yeah, I would probably put it at an A.
Okay.
The reason I say that, always want it to be better. You always want it to be better. But I was very pleased with our kids that they approached each day with a great mentality. We gave great effort. I thought we took care of each other. We played together. You see us, you see an inexperienced football team. And we've got to continue to grow our leadership and continue to build this team. But I thought we played hard. We practiced hard every single day. We didn't have a day where we walked off the field and said, that was sloppy. We didn't have great effort. We didn't have one of those days here this fall camp. So with that being said, and staying away from, staying healthy for the most part, you combine both of those and I'm pretty happy. That's why I feel like it's an A.
I don't know if you've got specific goals. And by that, what I mean by that is when you look at your offense, points per game, they've gone up three consecutive years. You guys were right at 30 points per game last year. Is there a number that you feel like this offense needs to be at this year?
Not necessarily. I think this is kind of what we judge our offense on is, number one, we want to dominate, or at least we want to control the line of scrimmage. Every run that we hand off, we want it to be an efficient run. Most people count 3 yards as an efficient run. We've added it to 4 this year. We're trying to, raise the bar. We want to have great ball security. You don't want any turnovers. That's the goal. 0 turnovers. We want to be right at 50% on third downs. We want to be at 90% in the red zone. And I know that's high. Most people have 70 to 75. But we feel like, when we get down in there, we got to punch it in and we're capable of doing it. And I know we're putting high goals for our team, but we've got to raise them high if we want to be something special. But to get to your answer, I know I'm running around it a little bit, but we don't necessarily talk about points. We talk about time of possession. We talk about finishing our opponent in the fourth quarter. And we talk about controlling the line of scrimmage and, winning the turnover battle.
Any concern at all for you on the play calling, the process of doing that and being the head coach, how all that's going to work tomorrow night? Because you've seen, great coaches who are great offensive coordinators eventually give up play calling duties, take them back, give them up, take them back. How's that process going to work tomorrow night?
Well, I don't plan on giving it up, to be honest with you. My plan is 100% to call it the whole season. I've called it for years. A lot of these guys have been grown up in this offense. A lot of these guys are back for their third year in it. And I've done it on the sideline the last 2 years. I'm comfortable doing it. The biggest thing that I'm having to deal with right now is just time management, because just being the offensive coordinator is an extremely demanding job. And then when you add the head coaching title to it and you're running the program as I am, it's just time constraining, but at the end of the day I can handle it. You just got to put more time in, get here earlier, stay a little later, have a couple more meetings and just continue the path. But I'm extremely comfortable calling it. These kids, I know these guys inside and out and what they're capable of, and I'm just excited to get to game day.
I don't know if Dan Lanning that well, the new Oregon coach. He's been around a while, but we just played a soundbite from him, and he talked about he's like, if a coach tells you he doesn't get nervous before the start of a game, I think he's lying. I'm always nervous. He said he goes to pee like 5 times in the locker room. I'm not going to ask you about that, coach, but, how nervous do you get before any game?
I really don't get nervous. I get excited. I get kind of – I guess the best – because I get that question a lot, and throughout my career, I don't get nervous. I get kind of amped up. I get kind of jacked up, and I get in a zone where it's a mentality that we're coming after you. And, bringing up Dan Lanning, Played him last year at Georgia, and I think that's why our point total, Lance.
It's pretty good defense, though. Hey,
they weren't bad.
Back to your OC duties. How many plays do you script out before a game? Like going into that game, you know, is it a full, you know, 8 to 10 plays? Is there a number that you typically have?
No, not really. I think what we do offensively is different. And what I mean by that is we're an outside zone team, and it's methodical. And we're going to run outside zone over and over and over and over. And then we've got all of our things off of outside zone where it all fits, whether it's our naked play actions, whether it's our regular play actions, it's our half row play actions. Everything's built off of outside zone. So it's not necessarily a 7 to 8 play script. It's more of a series thoughts. In this first phase to the second phase to the third phase to the fourth phase, because we're just going to be, you know, resilient in our run game and all the things that come off of it. And to me, when they start adding a guy from the field or from the boundary, then that's where we're going to attack them into play action. So everything's based off that. And it's more of a drive theory.
One more for me, and I hate to ask you all these X's and O's questions because, you know, I'm just a fan. I don't know football like a lot of guys who talk to you, but
I think he's figured that out.
Yeah, I mean, you know that. But I, how much, like your quarterbacks, when they get to the line, how do they have the keys to the car? Can they change in any play, or is it always a check with you before they change a play?
No, the keys are in the quarterback's hands. And everything up there that, well, he can walk up to the play, to the line of scrimmage, and he can change any play that we have. And the system's kind of built that way, depending on the play action protection, what can hurt it, what can't hurt it. You know, is it solid? Do I got to get out of it? Any run play we have, he's got the keys to. It just really, the quarterback has availability to change the play and check the play.
Good.
You mentioned the outside, and we'll let you go on this one, Coach. I know you got a lot to do, but you did mention the outside zone. Who is the father of that? Like, who do you watch that is a big, like you would say, this is the guy whose offense that I'm watching, I really want to emulate what they do?
I think it's really been App State. It goes back to 2018, 2019, and we've got a great relationship with those guys up there. They kind of started it. There's just a kind of a tree of them. Jeff Grimes at BYU is a good friend of mine that was at BYU and now is at Baylor. He's the offensive coordinator, offensive line coach. So it's really Baylor, App State, and Louisville are the three trees with a little bit of Missouri mixed in there.
All right. UAB tomorrow night. All right.
Tickets still left.
Tickets. Coach Ingram, Mark Ingram told us how to get those tickets yesterday. Also, tailgating starts at 1 o'clock. In spite of what you might have read, you can tailgate all day and then go watch the Blazers win at 7 down at Protective Stadium. Coach, thank you for the time today. Good luck. We'll see you next week.
Yeah. No pressure. It's my son. He's my freshman son's first UAB game, so no pressure.
Hey, no pressure. Hey, I promise you, he'll be excited. Thank you guys for having me. Go Blazers. And, hey, we're right up over 30,000. Let's pack this place out. Everybody
fantastic.
Come get your tickets and let's go. Fantastic. Appreciate you guys.
Thank you, Coach. Thank you. Take care. That is Coach Bryant Vincent, UAB. Coach, if you see Dunaway's son, have him call Jim and go see the game.